okay, Jimmy Rants, this is the deal. You're right. You're so freaking right. Everybody's so pissed off right now. Everybody's so depressed, so discouraged, so this, so that. Dudes, if you want anything, exercise your right to vote. Exercise your constitutional rights. That's what the Constitution was written for. It was written for us to be what we are today, the American people. Okay. Good example. On Facebook, social media, everybody was just a jibber jabbering around, you know, their meatloaf they made and their little statements. Okay, whatever, Facebook, do whatever you want. This happens to me all the time. I said, hey, everybody, love you, but I'm going to go ahead and put this picture up of the military because until those boys come home, those are my guys. Those are my brothers, my uncles, my grandfathers, my dads. That's who those guys are. They took an oath. Whether they should be there or not, I don't give a shit. You know what I give a shit about? I give a shit about our Constitution. I give a shit about exercising the right that was fought for you to have. They were in a sweaty room, but a lot of people don't know how big that Constitution is. They were in a sweaty room bickering out what that was going to be about, and they fought. And a lot of times the South didn't show up, but that was cool too. And they finally agreed on the Constitution of the United States. Our right to bear arms, our right to vote, our right to be a nation, our right to go and help people if they're unjust. Don't even get me started on Hitler. Great speaker, well-renowned speaker. Don't get me started. What I'm ranting about right now is that Obama sent me a letter. And he emailed me too. Nobody believed me. Nobody believed me. It's called whitehouse.gov. Sign up for it, guys. I petition all the time. If you want to flip the House, if you want to flip Congress, if you want to flip it, not rock the vote, babies, you need to vote. There's a period right there. It's a yes or no question. Don't be bummed out. Don't be pissed off. Don't be this. Don't be that. I don't care if you're any of those things. Actually, I'm not even sure you have a message when you're like that. Frustration's fine. The way you feel is okay, but do something about it. So if I feel like Walmart, I'm pissed off at them, you know, because they don't give me the peanut butter I want. Ask them, can I get the peanut butter I want? I mean, for God's sakes, you're a superpower. You know what they did? They got the peanut butter I wanted. I wanted a non-GMO, organic, no-stir peanut butter. They got it for me. I was sitting with the guy on an airplane. Yeah, this gets crazier. And I dumped my vegan nuts. I'll show you the bag. You see this? Who wouldn't spill it in an airplane? I spilt the peanuts into his crotch area. I'm a vegan. I'm like, oh, sorry, my non-GMO, nuts in your nut. My nuts are in your nut. Okay, so he says, oh, no big deal. I'm going to a conference in China. I'm like, conference? For what? Being the investigator detective that I am, right? And he said, well, I'm going to speak about GMOs, non-GMO. For Walmart. I was like, really? So why would Walmart go non-GMO? And he said, well, we're a superpower. Well, to hell with me. I've been going to the organic store buying this stupid peanut butter for $8. Same label, same name, made in the same facility. Walmart, $2.50, baby. Read it and weep. See, That's the stuff people get. They don't get pissed about. They don't get pissed about their food. They don't get pissed about this. They don't get pissed about that. They don't set up for survival. They don't know what to do with Ebola. Oh my God, they're worked up about this guy who died, whose autopsy came out. Dudes, think about it right now. Just think. What does my vote mean? That means your forefathers, and they have messed up too. Trust me, it's a lot of history there. But they fought. If you're so worked up about this one thing and you spend all your time talking about it and you're so lit up about it, go vote. Your vote does matter. And in the end, it is your right. Just like it's our right to work with the United Nations. It's just like I posted today on social media. It's an injustice when we don't do anything about injustice. Are we just? It's a question. Yes or no question. If there's an injustice going on outside my window, I hear a girl screaming one Thanksgiving. I open the window. She's running. What does that tell me? Somebody's in trouble. I open the door. She runs through the door. The guy was beating her up. That's unjust, isn't it? What do? You protect her. So I get my baseball bat and I said, bring it, mofo. Come on up in here. Because there's a woman that's about to serve you up something proper because this is my property, right? Boy didn't come in here, did he? Because he knew I'd say no. So she's standing here beat up on Thanksgiving. Old lady right here's got a baseball bat, and I'm like, bring it. I'll hit that sucker right out the park. You don't beat up no girl on my shift. You don't beat up anybody. I'm gonna be the first one to jump in there. So if I'm the first one to jump in there, I'm the first one to jump in on the vote. I'm the first one to say, no, I want better food. I'm the first one to say, that's not just, dude, or cool. I'm the first one because it's my right, because I'm American. I'm actually Mexican American. So don't even get me started on that and the grape fields. So don't even get me started on that. But I'm saying, the point is, I would never tell you how to vote. You're right, Jimmy. I would never tell anybody how to vote. But exercise the right to vote. Quit complaining, which you have the right to do. You are allowed to have an opinion. But if you're going to exercise that opinion, take it another step, man, and vote. And say, I matter still. I may not like my government. I may be mad, hurt, angry, disappointed, confused, don't know what the truth is. We'll find out later in a book, like 50 years from now, if we're still alive. And the truth is, you're an American citizen. You have the right to vote. You have the right to stand up for injustice. You have the right to bear arms. You have the right to protect your property. You have the right to be a good person. You have the right to be a bad person. That's what makes us free. Go vote, man. Stop complaining. Get to voting. Get your survival gear too, because you're going to need it. I promise you. I'm 49, it's coming. Just saying, Jimmy. I'm going to upload this on YouTube. I'm going to link it on this little post right here, because that's what I think. That's my rant, man. Holding it down in Colorado. Just came out of medical quarantine. I don't want to hear it, people. I told you I'd survive it. I did, because there was nothing wrong with me and I knew it. Point proven. I'm free. I'm white, 21, whatever they say. Actually, I'm not white, I'm more brown. Insanity. Take your right and use it and do it effectively the way you see fit. And that's what makes you empowered. And that empowerment is because we're American. Woo! Whole new shit show.